I'm so grateful to be back, and I'm grateful to be training hamstrings today. My hamstrings are something that, I'm not going to lie to you guys, before prep, I probably hit once, and it was because I didn't want to hit quads. It's slowly become one of my favorite days, and I put a lot of volume in, I put a lot of intensity in, and I'm excited to bring you guys through. That being said, car talk, I want to bring up cheat meals. For the sake of this example, I'm just going to be referring to meals that are not on your plan. This is like if you have a diet plan or something from a coach, say he goes, okay, and for a little break on Friday after you hit legs, you can go ahead and eat as much rice as you want, something like that. That would be structured. What I'm referring to is like an actual cheat meal where you are not telling your coach, you're not doing that. You're going out and getting a fucking burger. The more honest and truthful you are, the better the result will be. Compare it to, say, cheating at a board game, right? Like, say you're playing Monopoly or Uno, whatever, and you decide, okay, I'm going to cheat. Well, you might win. You might win the game, or you're going to get caught. You're going to get kicked out, and you're going to lose. So there's one or two options, right? You're either going to win or get away with it, or you're going to unequivocally lose. Same thing with relationships. Maybe you could get away with it, but you're not getting away with anything because in your heart, in your soul, you know to yourself that you weren't true. You know that you lied to yourself. And the only person that really fucking hurts at the end of the day is yourself. So if you're, you know, trying to lock in, you're trying to, maybe you're doing 75 hard, maybe you're doing just a bulk, maybe you're just doing a cut. All these things are extremely difficult. The point that I'm trying to bring home today is when you can live true to yourself, no matter what the outcome is, you will find success because you'll find success internally. You could fail on everybody else's metrics, but if you know in your own heart that you kept it 100 fucking percent, then you will win. And that's all I have to say today, boys. All right, y'all, so I'm prep. I'm training two leg days per week. On Tuesday, earlier on in the week, I have my quad day. It's usually the most intense training day of my week. And then on Saturday, I hit isolate hamstrings and I'll do one quad movement. So for today, we're warming up the adductors, abductors, and then we're gonna do a lying hamstring curl. We're gonna do a hip hinge on the machine, you'll see later. And then we're gonna do an RDL, a leg press, leg curl, and then we're gonna move on. This is not so extensive weight-wise, but it's very precise. With each set we wanna go in, maximizing how much tension we can get on the hamstrings, surrounding muscles, and basically just driving, you know, perfect form, focus on specific contraction. Another thing that's very interesting about prep, and even if you have a coach in any aspect, I've been blessed to have a coach for 2 years straight, so I've definitely felt levels of severity. But one thing that's really dope about prep is your diet plan is entirely reliant on how well you followed this week's diet plan and how good your check-ins look. So it could be Monday at fucking 6 o'clock. I have 7 days till my next check-in, but I'll be thinking, or I could be hitting fucking fingertips. You feel me? It doesn't matter. What if on my check-ins, my hamstrings are flat or don't look good or this or that? Or I'll be doing cardio. I'll put my hands on the thing and I'll think, oh fuck, what if I have X amount more water retention, blah, 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 more fat, this, whatever it could be, and my check-ins aren't on point. And it keeps you so fucking locked in because you just want to, on Monday, show up and be fucking on point so then your plan doesn't get lowered, right? So for shit like hamstrings, bro, it doesn't matter what I'm training. I'll be training, tired as fuck, I wanna quit a set, and I'm like, nah, I'm not stopping this shit, bro. I wanna be full,
I want to be lean. I want to look as best as possible when I'm actually taking my check-ins. With my RDLs, what I do is I do two basically warm-up sets where I do 25s and then another set of 25s. I do this for 10 to 15 reps just to make sure that my form's feeling good, controlling the tempo, overall getting the feel of the movement. Then I add a weight, so in this case a 45. So I'm doing about 245, I think. And I'm doing that for 8 really, really slow, controlled reps. It's kind of like a feeder set, getting my brain body connected on the weight that I'm using. And my next two sets will be working sets. So I'll be going to failure. Maybe I'll only do one working set and then I'll do a back off after that. Then we're gonna go move on to an isolation movement like a lying or seated leg curl. I have no idea how many I got. Half those pains or the sounds aren't even from the hamstring like overriding my central nervous system. It's just from like fucking like physical pain. These things are like death traps and they're vulnerable as hell. I don't know if this shit's in my head or not, but boys, when I wake up in the morning and when I train big muscle groups like back or legs of any sort, and also while I'm doing cardio, my breath tastes like ammonia, like bleach. And I think, I'm not 100% sure, but I think that I'm exhaling fat. I don't know if that's true or not, but it's pretty fucking nasty. That or like my kidneys are failing.
It's one or the other.
Yeah. I don't know how much of that was filmed, but that's like kind of what our sets look like. The reason my main working set wasn't filmed was because Keegan was pushing it with me, right? So I'd get about 10, 12, start hitting failure. He'd push me through, you know, 7, 8 more reps, drop the weight, do that again, drop the weight, do it again. This time we just did 2. So we did my first weight, which was 130, second weight, 115. Like I said, you know, reaching failure and then still achieving a full range of motion because of my spotter, which is Keegan in this example. And
Yeah, this is an exceptional movement. Super good, super locked in, doesn't really fuck with your lower back at all. Hits your hamstrings nice.
Our YouTube is currently 17 degrees. I'm not gonna be taking an ice bath like I would a year ago, because I'm not fucking weird anymore. Car. Anyways, thank you guys for watching this video. Comment, drop a comment for the algorithm. You know, I'll see you next week. I'm gonna be back, so that's good. Hopefully you learned something. Subscribe.